Yeah. Okay? We invented that. Okay? As far as I know, I ain't never heard nobody say C-dep. But you invented it with your actions. Okay? You created that word with your actions. You show that you've been committed. Okay? You've been disciplined. You've been given.
Welcome to Keep It 100, Coach Jones Show. How y'all doing this morning?
Doing pretty good. Licking those wounds.
You know, Coach, it's okay. We got a special guest with us today, Mr. Tango. Young man, I tell you, he looks sitting next to him, man. He make me and Coach Jones look small, and we both some pretty good sized guys. But Coach, I know you said licking some wounds, but there's no reason to be licking your wounds. You know, me and you've talked during the week. You know, a loss sometimes it makes you a better team, a better football player, and the things that you get to go work on, because sometimes you might think you're doing everything right until you get in the game and you're like, man, we should have done this and this and this. But like moving forward, and I know we'll talk about it throughout the show, but moving forward, you know, you lost your first game last year to Booker T.
Yes, sir.
And you redeemed yourself, and then went on a little run.
Yes, sir.
And so,
You know, like you said, every loss reveals character. So, first thing, how do you respond when you lose?
Yes, sir.
You know, it's easy to be talking about C-dep, talking about commitment, discipline, effort, pride, and toughness when you win, when everybody's praising you. But how do you respond when you lose? It was a very tough game. I think it was a historical loss. I mean, to be up by 10 with a minute and 40 left, I think it was a lesson learned that not only going to help these kids this year, but I think it'll help them in college. I think it'll help them in life. That you got to seal the deal when you get to that opportunity. You can't never feel like you have it. Like you said, last year when we lost to Booker T, the first game of the season, we went on to win 9 games in a row. And then we lost that heartbreaker to Sand Springs in the playoffs. And I think this is going to allow us to look in the mirror as coaches and players and evaluate some things that we need to change and make some changes that's going to help us make a run. I told the kids yesterday, let's go win 9 in a row.
9 in a row.
Like last year, if we win 9 in a row this year, we'll be holding up a gold ball. So that's our goal. You know, that hadn't changed. Our goal is to go win the state championship. Hats off to McAllister and their coaching staff and their players. They play their butts off. It was a tough physical fight. And I'm looking forward to being in those type of games. It was real exciting. I'm glad that the game lived up to its hype. And I'm looking forward to getting back this week versus Papa and taking it out on them. Because, you know, we're frustrated, we're upset, but that's the good thing about football. You get to play somebody else the next week. So we're looking forward to getting out here on homecoming and giving our fans a good show and showing that we are going to rebound. And this is a consistent program that's going to be able to play in big games week after week.
Well, Coach, you got to, like I said, we got this young man sitting between us. Tell the listeners a little bit about Mr. Tango. You know, comes over from Jarrell Marshall, a big part of the defense. And I saw him even Friday night. Line up with some tight end, catching a pass, and 32-yard pass. I think that could be something you guys can move forward, is you can use that two tight end set with him in form. And I even love to see this young man touch the ball, man. I'm telling you right now, I wouldn't want to get in front of him, Coach.
Yes, sir.
So I just, tell the listeners a little bit about Tango.
Like you said, Tango came over from John Marshall. Great character, has great pedigree coming from his father. His father played for John Marshall, won a state championship in 95, I believe. Did he play basketball as well?
Yes, sir.
So he played on the football team that was undefeated in 1995 and the basketball team that was undefeated, and they both won the state championship. And he played for Coach Griffin, who coaches for us, our basketball team now. So he has a great pedigree. His dad raised him right. He has great character. He's well-spoken. He's a great leader for us. If you didn't know Tango before then and you didn't know our program, you would have thought he'd been here all 4 years.
Yes, sir.
He leads our kids, and he not only leads by words, he leads by action. He prepares very well. He's very physical. And this is his first year playing linebacker. So to have a year that he's having to play the position from 1 year is outstanding. We are going to utilize him more at the defensive end spot because that's what he played at John Marshall. That's his comfort zone. He can get out to the quarterback. So just like you mentioned, offensively, we're having Foreman and Tango at the tight end positions. I think we can also utilize that on the defensive side of the ball and have them both at the defensive ends and getting pressure that way. So. I'm excited to see him continue to grow as a player and as a man. I'm excited to use him more offensively. I'm excited to see him get after the quarterback this week as we use him more as a defensive end spot, and we still use him as a linebacker spot. But, you know, he showed character after the loss too. You know, he was hurt. Everybody was hurt, but Tango was one of the main guys that was telling everybody we're going to be okay. We're going to rebound from this. Every setback is ready for a major comeback, and he really had that that aura about him that the kids were able to lean on him when they were going through that after the game. So I'm excited to see him continue to grow. I'm excited to see him lead our team.
That's good stuff. But Tango, we're going to turn it over to you and let you speak a little bit. Going into your senior year, you come over from John Marshall, like Coach kind of mentioned before. It seemed like you've been here all 4 years, but you kind of come right in and fit right in with these guys. And you already got a couple of guys that's already here, some superstars in Canigel and Foreman. But these guys brought you in as a brotherhood, not letting you not get in the circle. You're part of a big circle. So what's it been like to you being over here at Dell City?
It's been very good. These guys are already my brothers. Yes, I met Jayden Foreman at an OSU football camp when he got offered. So we got that relationship already. It's just football at the end of the day. Yes, we all click. We all had that in common. So we can just come together and work. And everybody got the same drive. It's the same goal. We want to win state. So it's easy to come together and just have that love and energy because we all want the same mission.
Well, Tango, like I said, coming from John Marshall, now you've been over here at Dell City. I know John Marshall hasn't probably won in a long time, and not taking that from John Marshall, it's called Keep It 100 Coach Jones. So, coming over here to Dell City with this winning tradition, Coach Jones been his second year as a head coach. His record speaks for itself, only having 3 losses and, 14 wins. It speaks highly for him and what he's done here at Dell City. So, what's it been like playing for Coach Jones?
I love it. I never played for a coach that was that passionate and cares that much for his players. So I have none but respect for Coach Jones, and I really appreciate him.
Well, that's good stuff. Like and one thing you got to say about you got to you got to pat yourself on the back because, like Coach said, you just played defensive end, but you come over here and you're playing linebacker. They've asked you to play different positions. I know you played some running back with Jarr Marshall. Now they got you playing a little bit of tight end. So what's the transaction been like, going, playing from linebacker to defensive end? Because the only thing, to me, I think that's going to help your recruiting base. So, colleges look like, hey, he can play defensive back, he can play tight end, he can play linebacker. So what's it been like to you learning these different positions?
It hasn't been that hard. At the end of the day, it's football. I just got to go home and spend more time just looking up the position and watching how to play the position and the right technique every day. My pops told me the more you can play, the more the better you're going
to
be.
Hey, amen.
The easier you can get recruited. So I just stuck with that. I play anything, special teams, offense, defense. It doesn't matter as long as I'm on the field.
So, taking that loss, Friday night against a good team, probably one of the better two-way players in the state of Oklahoma, Eric McCarty, young man, played excellent. You guys pretty much shut him down for 3 quarters. And me and Coach, kind of talked about it, for 34 minutes of the game, you guys dominated the game. He got loose on the screen play, and he got loose on the wheel route. And if you looked at the screen play, man, it really, I'm still a video junkie, even though I'm an old man. But if you looked at the game, and I went back and watched that play, he broke 6 tackles with some studs tackling,
Yes,
and so it's funny. It was like a movie, ending to a he's supposed to be the hero, and sometimes that happens, But I think, you guys are mad and sad, but at the end of the day, I think Coach Jones is gonna get you. Like you said, I was here when he lost to Booker T, and then I'm scratching my head like, man, it might be a long season doing this show. But then he got on the roll, and the kids started believing what he's saying. And so watching, Eric make that run, believe me, give it up to that young man. He had a hell of a game. But I just think that it's going to make you guys 10 times better because I think if you redid that play right now, he gets sacked. Because he should have been sacked in the backfield for a loss. But I just think that it's going to make you guys stronger. So, what would you tell your teammates to pick them up and say, hey, man, let's finish this strong?
I'll tell them at the end of the day, it's football and things happen, but we just got to execute, play our technique, and just make sure we're playing our assignments right and just keep driving and just be more hungry every day.
Well, you can see each day in college football, you watch these guys that's playing at the big Power 5 schools and they're blowing coverages and blowing assignments and missing tackles. It happens at every level, no matter if it's college, middle school, high school. college, NFL, it happens. So I just think with Coach Jones and like watching the coach in here this morning, watching film, getting you guys prepared, because I tell you, nobody takes that more hard on their sleeve. And I'm going to give it up to Coach Jones. He handled it really well because, you know, he said, T, you know, a few years ago, man, I've been screaming and, you know, cussing because nobody wants to lose. But growing up and teaching you guys, because that's part of life. And this is going to stick with you part of life. When you're sitting back one day with your buddies and you're like, man, you know, we lost that McCauley team and Eric did this. But, you know, when next time we're sitting here all together at the end of the year and you're holding that gold ball, it all pays off, because I'd rather you lose that game. And I've told Coach Jones, I'd rather you lose that game than lose the state championship game. So
yes,
I think Del C's in the right direction. You know, he's going to get you guys coached up and ready to go. But I got to ask you, though, about your recruiting. How's it going, though, so far?
It's going fair. I'm not getting that recruited that much, but I also am. It's been a couple schools coming to see me. I'm a late bloomer. Yeah, I didn't really start playing until my junior year. I was playing my sophomore year. I was playing 3-tech. I was about 5'8", 270. And then going into my junior year, I had a growth spurt. I was about 6 foot, and I lost a lot of weight. I was probably about 255. I started playing defensive end. Then I had a really good season. Then the off season, I came to Dell City. I hit the weights hard, lost a lot of weight, grew a little bit more. Now I'm about 6'1", 225, can move a lot better.
Yes, sir. Well, I'll tell you one thing about this man sitting next to you. He will do a good job getting you recruited. I watched Zach King last year, been a late offer, but ended up going to Houston Baptist, and then Coach Jones would stay on, and I'm telling you, I've been on the phone with him, man. I've seen text messages when these coaches are calling. He will put your name out there. And it's all eye test, Tango.
Yes,
like
sir.
I said, you know, one thing, you start putting that film out there and he started getting it out to these coaches. I mean, you are. You're going to be, I mean, you're sitting there saying, I'm a late bloomer, and you're exactly right. Somebody's going to jump on you, man, because you can't buy the size and the way you look, man. I'm telling you, your physique is good. You run good. I mean, and the thing is, you can play that cowboy back set. The other night when that pass was caught, I thought I was swarming. It was you, you know, and I was like, okay. But that just shows you your versatile with all the different things you can do, man. And just keep listening to Coach Jones and the coach, and you're going to be fine. I promise
you. Yes, sir.
Because right now, it's going to get hot. You still got a good game, and Tapopa comes in this Friday night, a good team. You know, they're fighting for a playoff spot, and you guys are still fighting for a playoff spot. And, you know, me and Coach Jones talked about this yesterday. If Coweta knocks off McCauley, then you guys knock off Coweta, and then you win the rest of the way out, you still can be the number one seed. And you're going to play some good teams, though. You know, I've been sitting there trying to put the puzzle together, like who's going to play who first round, because now it's exciting football. This is where it gets exciting about who's, because playoffs, everybody's going to be there to watch you guys and see what's going on. And like I said, the things that you're starting to do and you're doing, and I will tell you, the other night we didn't get a chance to talk to you. You used my player of the game. Me and RT both voted on that, man. You know, you had a couple fumble recovers,
yes,
caused
sir.
A couple fumbles, man. You was everywhere. So hats off to you, man. That's why we have you on this show today. So I really appreciate your game and in your the way you carry yourself, man, is big time. Big time. Well, Coach Jones, like I said, man, it's good to bring this young man on. We'll let him get the class and get that education, because that's the most important thing.
Absolutely.
And anything, closing words on him before we let it go?
Yeah, like he said, he's going to make a college coach very happy.
Oh, yes, sir.
Because when you have a guy that can play Mike backer, but can play outside backer, that can play defensive end, H-back, fullback, tailback, college coaches are going to be so excited about his size. And with the recruiting is so different now with the transfer portal.
Yes, sir.
So it happens a little later throughout the season. These coaches are going to start coming around. I haven't really been focusing on that yet. I wanted us to get a good foundation in district. But when, like I've always said, if you go take care of business and you prepare yourself like he has, and he's making plays on film, that film ain't going to lie. So
yes,
I have
sir.
No doubt that he's going to have some opportunities to go get a free education. And I have no doubt that they're going to get a young man that works his butt off. One thing about him and Canigel, since I've been coaching for 19 years, these two guys, when we condition, they leave nothing on the table.
That's it.
They run through the line. They give everything they got. So I'm very confident in speaking about him to college coaches, because I know he's going to get on campus and he's going to make a player at whatever position that they choose. So I'm excited to see him continue to grow. I'm excited to see him grow into this program and lead us as we make this run to get into the playoffs and rebound from this loss. It was a tough loss, but I really think, like you said, Tony, you kind of gave me some positive reinforcement that really helped me. Sometimes if you look at your life, every person has some heartache, some yes, things sir. That were tough and you had to go through adversity. But if you maintain yourself and you stick to your values, you usually come out on top as a better person. So I think this program is going to be a better team from this loss. I think we're going to learn from it. I think you guys will see a great product out there this Friday. I don't think it's going to be a game where we kind of slack off. And I give all the respect to Sepulpa. They're a great team. I'm really looking forward to this matchup and seeing what Tango can do and the rest of our defense can do and our offense can do as well.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well, folks, we'll be right back after one of our sponsors. Keep it 100 to Coach Jones. So be right back. Back to Keep It 100 Coach Jones Show. Coach, like I said, we just had Mr. Tango in here, a great looking young man. Yes, I know sir. All the girls who are at Dell City probably chasing him, man, you know. I tell you, man, comes from, like you said, talked about his father,
yeah.
You know, played at John Marshall,
yes,
was a state championship in basketball and football, and that's hard to do in this day and age.
Yes, sir. It hadn't happened in a while, and me and Coach Hatchett talked about that. We want to do something like that, and we want to be able to be the first team to win. Carl Albert did it a few years back. I can't remember.
You know, the deal about Carl Albert, the times they won state championship, they've always lost one game or,
yeah.
You know.
Never undefeated.
Undefeated. So, yeah. But, Coach, you know, we're going to get into this game a little bit. Like I said, you know, you lose a heartbreaker, man, you know, by 1 point to a great team. You know, both teams, you know, like I said, we talked last week, you know, we did it on the field. You know, both teams come in as number one and number two, and some polls both teams number one.
Yes.
You know, did the better team win the other night? You know, for 34 minutes, you beat them up and down the field. You know, you control Eric. I will say that young man is a tackling machine. I was really impressed.
Man, I was very impressed by that. I think he's going to have an opportunity to do some great things at OU. And they can use him now. That's what I was about to say.
Like, keep it at 100. Yeah. They can use it right now. But, No. I just think, like you said, I mean, you know, it's a tough loss.
Yes.
But, you know, I thank these young men and woke them up. And sometimes you need that wake-up call. And you know that. You played at the, you know, at the highest level in college football. So, you know, there's games that, you know, you guys should have won and you did win. And next week you got to come out. And then you kind of talk about the young men coming out this week in practice. How has practice been this week?
Well, you know, it's been great because when you lose like that and you have to look in the mirror and you start to – work on things that you need to work on. We got to be better in the red zone offensively.
Yes, sir.
You know, we got in the red zone, I want to say, three times. We had to settle for Stanley missed one of the field goals, which he's usually reliable. He missed the field goal, but he made two.
Yeah, I think it was two or three.
Yes, if we get into it, if we get two touchdowns out of those three, the game's a different game. Even when we got down there late, instead of kicking the field goal, if we score, it changes the momentum of the game. It changes how they approach things. So we got to be better in the red zone. We got to use our weapons a little bit more and utilize our speed. Special teams, you know, that's the first time this year that we did not dominate on special teams. We had a kickoff return for a touchdown with Stanley. I told Stanley, there's something with the mojo of you when we start to get the momentum in these big games. You have a kick that lets them capture the momentum back.
Yes, sir.
Choctaw. We were up by 17 points. We kick it off, and then, you know, he squibs it on accident, and they return. And then the next play, they return to the 50. The next play, they score. Sand Springs, same thing. Then last week, we're up by 14-0, and I just felt the energy coming out of them. Like, I felt that because when you're down 14-0 on a big game like that, I just felt like we were kind of getting on top of them. Then they take that kickoff return back, and then they go through. We go through and out, and then they block a punt.
Yes.
So, special teams really had a factor in that game. I know Coach Shields, so we're working on some things there and putting some personnel on kickoff with Kanijah, Braylon, and Omar. So we'll fix that. So this week has really been about fixing the things that cost us in that game and also adding things that are going to help us make this playoff run. Because the way it works in football, everybody is in midway through the season.
Yes, sir.
You know who you are. You know what you have. So now you have to start getting things set up to make this run to get in the playoffs. So it's not guaranteed.
No.
You know, we're talking about a state championship, but you have to go through the process of getting in the playoffs first. And that's this week. We have another district game. And Sepulpa is a great, great team.
No, they're
3-2. They beat Tahlequah, they beat Bartlesville, and they beat Durant, and they played Sand Springs, which beat us in the playoffs 35-21. I think the score against Coweta doesn't indicate what type of team they are. They're a former 6A2 team. They have a great quarterback. They have some receivers. They have a great offensive line. Defensively, they attack. You know, when we watch the Coweta film, if you didn't know the score, you don't see a 55-14 score. They play physical. Like I said, they have 6A numbers. They're a great football team. We're going to have to come out and play a very, very precise, detail-oriented game to come out here and get this victory. So I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, I mean, like you said, they come in like 3-2, but like I said, they had some tough games. I mean, and it all sets itself up because, you know, right now everybody's jockeying for the number 1 and 2 seed because you want to have that home field advantage.
Absolutely.
For your first couple of games. Home number 1 seed is great because you don't go on the road into, semifinals.
Yes.
You play the neutral site. But I tell you, though, man, it's you know, these next few weeks are going to, it's going to have the puzzle, solved because, you know, you got Big Week, you got Bishop McGinnis and Guthrie play this
yes.
week. You got Coweta and McAllister play this
yes.
week.
And that's a short week.
Yeah, short. Yeah, it's a tough. Yeah, it's a short
right
week.
Yes, sir.
And then you have, you got yourself in Sapopa, which yes. You guys are both battling to keep your head above water. And whoever can get this win, and if like I said, if Coweta can knock off McAllister, then you can knock off Coweta at the end of the year and put you back in the driver's seat. So this week is these next 4 weeks is going to be amazing high school football in all the classes. We're going to talk over some numbers. Like I said, for 34 minutes you dominated the game.
Yes.
They got loose on a couple on a wheel route, and they got loose on the screen, both to the same side.
Yes, sir.
Poor tackling is all going to come down to it. And hey, if we wrap him up in the backfield, hey, he's done. I mean, really, he should have been. Because we kind of talked about the rushing yards. I guess they use that pass
up until that point, we have held him to, up until a minute 40, we only gave up 6 points to him. It was 23-13, and they scored on the kickoff return. And he had, number one had 58 yards rushing.
Yes, sir.
And they did a great job setting that up. That is a great job of that coaching staff. They knew that Aaron had been flowing away from it, so they set it up perfectly. And I told Aaron, that's on me, because I knew all week that they were going to use him out of the backfield, because anytime since I've been coaching, and it was similar when Bishop McGinnis had Dominic Richardson, they're going to use Will routes and use him out of the backfield.
Yes, sir.
And I told Aaron all week, and I told Tango, but I didn't run the plays enough. I didn't work them enough in practice. I was worried about stopping other things. So this week we've been really working Will routes. We've been working the back out of the backfield because football is a copycat type situation.
Oh, yeah, everybody's going to try to put it in their
everybody's
playbook.
Everybody's going to put that in their playbook. So hopefully we can show ourselves that we're able to go out there and stop it, because we need to get over that mental block, because they're going to do the same thing this week, and they got a very talented back. So I take part of that blame because I didn't work it in practice. But Aaron and the defense has to learn how to transfer what we're telling them on timeouts. But we called a timeout, and I told both outside backers, I said, hey, they're about to run some wheel routes. They're about to do this.
Be ready for it.
Kanija was a deep safety, and he chases a crossing route. I said, Kanija, anytime you're the deep safety and you know you got a big-time player like that, you need to kind of shadow him and erase that mistake like he kind of did versus Choctaw. So it was a learning process for myself and the kids. This week, I really feel like my defense is going to get our anchor back down and get back going. The kids are really upset. They've been practicing physical. They've been real humble. I like the groundwork that they're putting back in to
yes,
be
sir.
Able to overcome that loss. And Sapopa brings a unique challenge to us because they're able to – they run some formations similar to McAllister, but they're also a spread team, and they got a pretty legit quarterback as well. And they got a couple athletes at receiver. So I'm looking forward to the challenge of getting back out there and getting this taste out of our mouth and going out and having a fun time and homecoming as well.
Yes, sir. Like I said, we'll talk about some numbers real quick. Dell City ended up with 306. McAllister Buffaloes ended up with 374 passing. D Good, D Nice, we call him, was 11 for 22, 167 yards, 1 TD. Hit Canines on that long one. One interception. We kind of talked about the turnover game.
Yes.
It hurts. They were going into rushing. Braden Adama, he had 20 carries for 74 yards, 1 TD, 1 fumble.
Yes.
There you go. Then you had D Green. Jaden Green with 12 carries for 47 yards. 28. Is that the freshman?
Yeah, that's Shaden Green. He's
I'm sorry,
a sophomore.
Sir.
He's a sophomore.
I'm sorry, D Nice. I'm sorry. Let me get this right. QB had 12 carries for 47 yards.
Yes.
And to me, Coach, and I know you've seen this on film, as a couple of times he could have took off and been like a Hurst for the Philadelphia Eagles and go get the first down.
Yes.
I know when you was driving at the end of the game and it got down to fourth down, I know everybody's over there biting their nails and Kanijah, and I'm telling you, if you didn't see the game, then Kanijah comes up with a big time catch, catches low, he gets the first down, it's fourth and 10.
Oh, yeah.
You don't get this, you don't get a chance to kick the field goal to send it overtime. A couple of times, you know, D. Nice could have took off and ran it and got the first down, and that's something, and that comes with experience. So the more and more he plays, you'll see that. A couple of times he could have ran and got 20, 25, 30 yards, maybe took a couple to the house and got out of bounds and saved the timeout. But Green, now he's number 28 now. He's a freshman?
He's a sophomore.
Sophomore.
Yes.
Coach, I'm going to tell you right now, I'm not on your staff. I know we just do the show. This young man is going to be special.
Yes.
He
had
one carry for 28 yards, and I remember when he got in the game, he had that run, and I'm thinking, who is that?
Yeah, we got to give him the ball more.
Yeah, not taking that from the other back, but I'm saying when you got that kind of – them type of athletes that sit on the sideline, folks, I'm telling you, the kid had one run.
Well, this is the DLT, and we got to do a better job as a staff, and I got to do a better job as a head coach. Braylon starts a safety. So, when you know, maybe those fumbles came from exhaustion.
Yeah, tired.
You know, you're playing both ways.
Yes,
you're
sir.
Playing against a very physical team. You have to make tackles. You're going to play running back. And we have Shaden Green on the sideline. So that was a big emphasis that I wanted to correct as a head coach is we got to get him some carries. And we got to get him the ball more to give Braylon more of a break to be able to.
Be ready in fourth quarter.
Yeah, be ready in fourth quarter to run the ball and be ready more on defense to make some plays. So we're going to take care of that. I didn't mention this earlier, but for the momentum to happen like it did, and I know we keep talking about last week, but it's such a growing point for us. I want to bring this up so the kids can hear it. To be able to give up that lead and come back and tie it up to overtime, that showed me that our kids have bought in to C-Dep all the way.
Yes, sir.
Because it's easy to be a front runner. It's easy to be a front runner. We could have easily said, man, we lost this game, this and that. No, they came back and to get that fourth down conversion. Then Stanley to come back and make that field goal at the end of regulation.
And they called timeout. They tried to ice him.
Yeah, so that showed me that our kids have bought in and that they can overcome adversity. But like you said, we have to get number 28 the ball more.
He's
very explosive. He can do some crazy things. And what's so scary is we have another running back behind him that you guys will get to see. I have Mike Backer more this week. He'll kind of trade in and out with Tango. And then also playing running back as well because he's another weapon. So I'm excited to see.
Yeah, he's excited. He's exciting too.
Yes, sir.
You know, Farski, you know, like I said, D-Nice was, 11 for 22 for 167 yards. Kanijah had three catches for 60 yards. And I think, granted, that touchdown catch was good. But I think that fourth down and 10 catch was the thing that really kept the chains going. Jay Sweet was six catches for 62 yards.
Big game.
Good game, Tango, the one catch. And, when Tango caught the ball, I'm thinking Foreman. I said, okay, Foreman, I see.
Yeah.
And it's Tango. So there's a lot of different weapons you can use that you can do. And then, Jay Burrs at one catch for 10 yards.
Yeah.
So he spread the ball around a lot.
Absolutely.
He really did. But like I said, I know Day-Day's a young man. That's going to steady film and watch the games to get himself better. But there's some things, like I said, the taking off, I think he can do that and slide when he needs to slide.
I think what's happening with him is in the offseason, we worked so much because Virgil was a guy
Virgil would just take off.
As soon as he sees it one time, he take off. So all offseason and in the summer, we like, Daddy, stay in the pocket.
Man.
Now we have to learn how to have a balance there. Yeah, we want you to stay in the pocket, but
sometimes you got to take off
rushing three.
Yeah,
I'll take Daddy on any linebacker in the state one-on-one in the open field. So he needs to learn how to do that with the experience that he's getting.
Coach, I will say though, man, for the offensive line though, you got to give a lot of credit. But I don't know if there's any sacks, and if there was, it was very, very few.
It was cover sacks.
But for the most part though, man, they did a great job giving him the time. I know they rushed three, but still. They did a great job giving him the opportunity to go. And like I said, we talked about Stanley. He was 2 for 3 with field goals.
Yes, sir.
Defense played pretty much lights out. McAllister, like I said, they had a great game plan. They made some adjustments at halftime. And you had, like I said, you had to lead the whole game. So it's kind of, you had people texting you telling you good game because they thought you had won the game. And the funny thing is, we're keeping up with the Keep It 100 team. We're keeping up. And you go up 23 to 13. So I'm fixing to send this tweet because I'm tweeting all through the game.
Yeah.
And Ethan and RT says, hey, put ball game. And as soon as I get up, no lie, coach, I had just typed it up. As soon as I get ready to send, he goes, he takes
that. Y'all jinxed us.
Yes! So I told RT, I said, what do I tweet? He said, don't tweet nothing yet. Don't tweet nothing yet. But at the end of the day, it's a great ball game. It's good to see you smiling. It's a lesson learned. And think about it. It's only going to make you better, man. And I know, you know, it's easy. Somebody saying that. Yeah. But at the end of the day, it's still tough because at the end of the day, everybody wants to go undefeated. But you have not shortened the goal. The goal was to win a state championship.
Absolutely.
No one cares about going undefeated. That's cool.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, it's about winning that gold ball. And I still think Del C's on the right path to do that.
Absolutely.
Everybody stay healthy. You get some guys, you know, like I said, if you can get some of those younger guys, because they're not freshmen no more. They're sophomores now.
Absolutely.
We're in week six. So you growing up, boy, you taking some hits and you know what's going on. Absolutely. But before we let this go, though, how's the JV team doing? I know we don't talk much about them.
I didn't get to mention it last week. We beat Guthrie in a close ball game. I believe it was 21-13. And they're a great program, man. Guthrie, those kids come and hit you. They play hard physical football. Then we beat John Marshall this Monday 62-0. I hate to do that. I really feel sorry for some of the Oklahoma City public schools. I really hope they get those schools going in the right direction because I did play there before at U.S. Grant. So a lot of and the JV kids in our program in freshmen because we practice our freshmen and with our varsity and this is why we're having so much success with some of our younger players because they're running our scout team.
Yes, sir.
So every day they're going against the Canigers and Tangos and the Foremans. The Godwins, the Sweets, they're practicing against them on a daily basis.
Making them better.
So when they do get in the game, if somebody has an injury or next year when their number's called on, they're going to be ready because they're going to get some of the top players in the state. So we wouldn't be where we are without those kids. I'm so excited to see them continue to grow. I'm excited that they are bought into the program to where they're not pouting, they're not complaining because they're not getting reps. They're just going out there and getting better every day. And then to my coaching staff, I told them Sunday in our coaches' meetings, I said, guys, don't you hang your head down one bit. No. I said, all up to a minute and 40 seconds left, you went toe-to-toe and coached against one of the best coaching staffs in the state. So don't hang your head down. Look in the mirror, see what we can fix, and let's get it fixed, and let's go make this run. Because I didn't know historically, because I was going in Texas, but McAllister's been winning in the last 20 years a lot of football.
Yes, sir.
So this is only our second year together as a coaching staff. That coaching staff's been together for a while. So as we continue to grow together as a coaching staff, I think sky's the limit. I think our program is only going to continue to get better each year. So I'm excited about seeing us grow together and seeing where we can go as a coaching staff.
Yeah, I know you talk about your coaching staff. I thought he did a good job over there watching him on the sidelines, you know, watching both teams, you know, go back and forth. Like I said, you know, we had talked about it before. It was like a heavyweight, you know, boxing match. Forrest gave me a chance to, you know, Coach Mason gave me a chance to talk to him before the game.
Yeah.
A lot of respect for Del City. And even if, you know, if you watch the Eric McCarty's interview at the end, of the, you know, he talks about, hey, Del City.
That was very awesome to hear him say that, man.
Yeah.
To hear him say, like, hey, guys, you guys are some dogs. We'll see you in the state championship.
That's big time.
That's big time. You know, most of the time, most kids are going to be bragging. And you know, we had a game earlier this year where somebody said if we played them at home, we would win 100 out of 100. I'm not going to say that about McAllister.
Yeah.
Hey, they beat us.
Yeah.
It wasn't nothing about the refs. It wasn't nothing about anything else. They showed up and we played a football game and they beat us. So for him to be able to have that sportsmanship at the end of the game, that was awesome. You could tell Coach Mazie does a great job over there
because
he showed great character in winning and not bragging.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well, folks, man, like I said, to be come out this Friday night support the Del City Eagles, they get back on the winning streak, you know, as they take on the Sepulpa Chiefs and their homecoming. I know this is a big week, not just because we're back at home playing, you know, trying to get back on that winning streak, but homecoming, you know. I know you got to deal with all the candy and the dresses and the suits and the nice shoes the young men going to put on. But
yes,
it's a good thing for Del City, though, man. I just tell you, I love the support that you have for the family. You know, Foreman said something the other day. I read one of his quotes in his tweet. He said, man, people love you when you win and they hate you when you lose.
Yes.
And that's the thing about it, man. And one thing that you always say, control what you can control.
Mm-hmm.
And it's okay. It's okay to lose, people. Believe me, we've all had some kind of adversity in our life.
Yes.
And listen, watching Tango here, hey, I'm telling you right now, these guys are hungry, man. It's like putting some steaks out there to some pit bulls, and they're ready to go get after it. So,
man.
Coach, you keep doing what you're doing, man. I mean,
yes,
don't
sir.
Hold your head down because I said, for a young coach at you know, for second year, you know, sitting at 14-3, a lot of coaches like to be in that position in their first 2 years of where you're at, and it's not going to stop there. So good luck to you and the Del City Eagles, and keep flying high, okay?
I want to give it, before we go, I want to give a shout out to you guys, the community, the administrator, the teachers, the faculty, everyone. That was a big historical game.
Yes, sir.
We really had the eyes of the state on us. I want to give a shout out to the McAllister fans. They were very respectful.
It was.
The coaching staff was very respectful. I love, That's what it's about. It's about two teams that are ranked high, high expectations for both, coming together and giving the fans and giving the community what they want. We gave them a great game. I just want to thank everybody for coming out and supporting us and supporting that game. That was big time.
Well, I want to give a big shout out before we go to, we got to give a shout out to Shannon. I mean, he gets set up week in, week out. I know he does a lot of stuff behind the scenes. People don't get to see him, but he does a great job getting us set up every day when we come in here for a show. He has a setup of his defense out there on the field. If he's in here, he's ready to go.
Awesome
so
yes,
he does, we man. So shout out to him. But like I said, come out for this Friday night, support the Dale City Eagles as they take on the Pope and Chief. Kickoff time be at 7 p.m. Come cheer Coach Jones and the boys on, because I tell you right now, he will get them back on the win streak. And thank you again for watching the Keep It 100 Coach Jones Show. We'll see you next time.
City, I put on for my city, on for my city.